Hi friends, how are you? Hope you are good. You are staying safe at home. So you'll be waiting for your school to reopen, right? You're waiting for back to school. Even we, the teachers, are waiting for you. Okay. So let us pray together. Let our school start at the earliest. Now, we'll start with our class. Okay. Are you ready? Shall we start? Lesson 1. The name is Computer Memory and Storage Devices. You know, we all have memory, right? Where is our memory? Yes, we store it in our brain. Where is our brain? Here. Inside this skull, we have a brain. Same way, computer is also having a memory, and that is called computer memory. And storage devices. There are some devices which are used for storing the data. Let us move forward. Computer memory and storage devices. You might have studied in third standard about input, process and output. You know, we need input devices for doing the input and processing, which is done by CPU. And output devices are used for producing the result. So, computer memory is working into the IPO. What do you mean by I? I stands for input, P for processing, and O for output. Input, processing, output. What a user does? What do you mean by user? Means a person who is using the computer is called a user. Suppose I am using the computer, I am the user. You are using the computer, you are the user. So what does the user do? What does the person do? A person who is using the computer feeds data into the computer. Feeding data means working on the computer. How they are working on the computer? First, they are using the input devices. What are they doing? They are using the input devices. So, what a user do? A user feeds data into the computer using the input devices. Next one. Then what happens? What is the second step? Yes, you are correct. The second step is processing. How does the computer do it? The computer then works upon the input with the help of the processing device. Further, the computer will work by using the processing device. Finally, it will declare the result by using the output devices. What is the last step? By declaring the result by using the output devices. So, what are the three things a computer does? It is input, processing, output. How do we do input? By using the input devices. How do we process? By using the processing device. And how the result is produced? Obviously, by using the output devices. Now you will be thinking, what is computer memory? Okay, let me say, computer memory is divided into primary memory as well as secondary memory. Now, what is primary memory? What do you mean by primary memory? What is the function of this primary memory? You know, our eyes. Why do we use our eyes? For seeing, right? For ears, for hearing, and nose for smelling. Same way, primary memory also has some functions. What are the functions of primary memory? What it is doing, primary memory contains the computer programs and instructions that can be directly read by the CPU. What it is doing, it is containing the programs and instructions. What are the instructions? Whatever we give instruction, that are the instructions that is directly read by the CPU. Then, primary memory has got another name. What is that name? Yes, it is also called as internal memory. Primary memory is also called as internal memory. Again, primary memory is further divided into two, and they are RAM, ROM. So, how many types of primary memory are there? Very good. Two types. One is RAM and the other one is ROM. Can you see the picture of ROM? Now, what is the full form of ROM? Yes, read only memory. Please repeat along with me. Read only memory, ROM. What is the function of ROM? The ROM is located on the motherboard of the computer. Where is motherboard? Yes, it is inside the CPU. So, where is ROM located? Inside the motherboard of the computer. So, what does ROM contain? Yes, ROM contains some instructions and programs that are essential for a computer to operate. So, read-only memory contains instructions and programs that are essential for a computer to operate. Now, what are this, how this ROM works? They are actually a permanent type of memory and it cannot be changed by the user. Okay, you and me cannot change it, and that is why it is called as the permanent memory or non-volatile memory. The content of RAM does not get lost even when the computer is turned off. So, because it is inside the motherboard, even if we switch off the computer, we will never lose our data. It is permanently stored over there. That is why ROM is also called as the permanent memory or non-volatile memory. And we said there are two types of primary memory. One is ROM and the other one is RAM. What is the full form of RAM? Random access memory. What is RAM? RAM is the working memory of a computer system. How does it work? It is attached to the slots on the motherboard. On the motherboard, there is a special space for RAM. And when we work on the computer, the software we use are temporarily stored onto the RAM. It is temporarily stored into the RAM. Then when we turn off the computer, the RAM loses all the software and the data. Suppose if we are working and suddenly the power goes off, so what will happen? We will lose all the data in RAM. So that is why RAM is called the temporary storage device. Why? Because when we switch off the power supply, we will lose the data. So data can be read and written in RAM. We can read data, we can even write in RAM. That is why RAM is also known as the read and write memory. Okay, so we studied primary memory. Primary memory is having two types of memory, ROM and RAM. What is the full form of ROM? Read only memory. And what is the full form of RAM? Random access memory. So let us revise what we studied today. First one, lesson name is computer memory and storage devices. How does the computer work? Yes, by input, processing, output cycle. How do we feed the data? By using the input devices. How we do the processing? By using the processing device. And how do we get the result? By using the output devices. Now the computer's memory is divided into primary memory and secondary memory. What do you mean by primary memory? It means the programs and instructions that is directly read by the CPU. What is the other name for primary memory? It is called the internal memory. Primary memory is again further classified into two, RAM and ROM. What is ROM? Read only memory. Where is it located? It is located on the motherboard of the computer. And what does it contain? It contains some instructions and programs that are necessary for the computer to operate. Is it permanent type? Yes, it is permanent type of data. And what is the other name for permanent memory? It is also called the non-volatile memory. What does the computer lose the data when it gets off? No, it does not get the data lossage. What do you mean by RAM? Random access memory. What is RAM? It is the working memory of a computer system. When we work on computer, it is temporarily stored onto the RAM, and when we turn off the power, what will happen? We will lose all the data. So it is also called as the temporarily storage data or volatile memory. We can read and write data in RAM, and that is why RAM is also known as read and write memory. That's all for today. Thank you. Have a good day.